Thank you for coming on this gorgeously beautiful day. I have a couple of announcements to make, just because we've had some changes. Walker Jackson is the tenor soloist, because our tenor soloist, otherwise Bernard, woke up today with laryngitis. Okay. Michael Heller is reading today from Gary Larkin. Gary Larkin is the editor of the Riverdale Press, and he has COVID. Okay. Elizabeth Lee, who is a law student, is reading for our hip-hop artist, Jason Regalado. And Ben Spierman is reading for Valerie Capers. I also want to introduce our great host for this afternoon, the president of Lehman College and becoming my very good friend, Fernando Delgado.
So I stand between you and performance, and well, they all seem ready. Those of us in the green room, we've still got a little flop sweat going. I'm up here not to do anything other than to say thank you for coming to our campus. Those of us who work at Lehman take great pride in our campus, and we like to share it with everybody in the Bronx and the five boroughs and beyond. And in particular, we'd like to share it for those of you who come from Manhattan. Not because we have anything against you, Manhattan, but we like to show off for the people from Manhattan, because it sometimes makes us feel fancy in the Bronx. My purpose up here, however, is really about Michael. It's about you, Michael. And you have to be quiet for a minute. So I've known Michael for about 2 years. I've been president for about 30 months, so I've known him for most of my presidency here. He first scrambled up into our offices at a time when very few people wanted to meet face to face, but he felt it was important to introduce himself and what he does here, and to remind me as a new person how long he's done it and why the partnership matters, both to him and his colleagues, but to us at the college and to people in the Bronx. And I listened, and we chatted, and I asked some questions, and he had very good answers, and we said goodbye. And I began to talk to other people about this interesting person I met who had a lot of energy, more than I did. And they said, oh, you met Michael Spierman. And I said, yeah. And they said, yeah, you said energy, and you know, we knew it was Michael. And I said, oh, cool. And so a profile began to emerge of Michael. And that's why I'm standing before you today. So for 50 years, Michael has been a performer, an activist, and an educator. He's done it with gusto. He's done it with excellence. He's done it with sweat and tears and elbow grease and ingenuity and everything else that talks about grit and resiliency that reflects well on the Bronx. And he's done it because he has a passion for the arts and he has a passion for our community. And so typically what I'm about to do, I would do it in front of a gathering of just Lehman people. And we feel like we're part of the Bronx. It's part of our mission. It's the legacy of what Herbert gave us, civic engagement and public service. But the more I thought about it, and I discussed it with Michael and his family, you are his people. These are his people. And we at Lehman are simply a subset of Michael's universe. And so I thought it was most appropriate here. And so periodically, at my discretion, or at any president of Lehman College's discretion, we can do something. And we do it based on somebody's commitment, somebody's excellence, somebody's years of service, somebody's relevance to the college and our mission, and beyond that, somebody who makes a positive impact in the Bronx. And so here on this day, as we're about to participate in Handel's Messiah, during a season for those of us who, like myself, are Catholic or Christian, who believe in this season, and who at least buy into the consumerism, that this is at least an opportunity to give gifts, I have an opportunity to bestow a gift on Michael. And so in front of all of his friends and family, and maybe a couple of acquaintances, we don't know. Michael doesn't know everybody, despite what he tells me. That, see, you say I'm funny, that one died. So that was a bad joke. I would like to bestow upon Michael Spierman the Lehman College of the City University of New York President's Medallion. People ask me what's the best part of my job outside of commencement, that. Thank you.
Now to the Messiah. Thank you.
Comfort ye, my people, saith your God. Speak ye comfortably to Jerusalem, and cry unto her that her warfare is accomplished, that her iniquity is pardoned. The voice of him that crieth in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be exalted, and every mountain and hill made low, the crooked straight, and the rough places plain.
Of him that crieth in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Shall be exalted. Shall be exalted. Shall be exalted. And every mountain and hill made low. The crooked straight and the rough places plain. The crooked straight, the crooked straight. every valley shall be exalted. Every valley shall be exalted.
And the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord hath spoken it.
Yeah.
Thus saith the Lord of hosts, yet once, a little while, and I will shake the heavens and the earth, the sea and the dry land, and I will shake all nations, and the desire of all nations shall come. The Lord whom ye seek shall suddenly come to his temple, even the messenger of the covenant whom ye delight in. Behold, he shall come, saith the Lord of hosts. But who may abide the day of his coming, and who shall stand when he appeareth? For he is like a refiner's fire.
A little while, and I will shake the earth and the earth, the sea and the dry land, and I will shake, and I will shake all nations. I'll shake the earth, the earth, the sea, the dry land, all nations. I'll shake, and what is suddenly come to his temple, even the messenger of the covenant whom he delight in. Behold, he shall come, saith the Lord of hosts. Thank you.
And he shall purify the sons of Levi, that they may offer unto the Lord an offering in righteousness.
Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel, God with us. O thou that tellest good tidings to Zion, get thee up into the high mountain. O thou that tellest good tidings to Jerusalem, lift up thy voice with strength, lift it up. Be not afraid, say unto the cities of Judah, behold your God. O thou that tellest good tidings to Zion, arise, shine, for thy light has come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon thee.
Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel. God with us.
Behold, For behold, darkness shall cover the earth, and gross darkness the people. But the Lord shall arise upon thee, and his glory shall be seen upon thee. And the Gentiles shall come to thy light, and kings to the brightness of thy rising. The people that walked in darkness have seen a great light, and they that dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them hath the light shined.
Thank you. Unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace.
The Mighty God, the Everlasting Father. There were shepherds abiding in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said to them, "Fear not, for I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born that day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord." And suddenly, there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and peace on earth, goodwill toward men."
There were shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flocks by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people.
Rejoice greatly, O daughter of Zion. Shout, O daughter of Jerusalem. Behold, thy king cometh unto thee, and he shall speak peace unto the heathen.
Thank you. His yoke is easy. His burden is light.
Behold the Lamb of God that taketh away the sin of the world.
Thank you.
He was despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. He gave his back to the smiters and his cheeks to them that plucked off the hair. He hid not his face from shame and spitting.
Acquainted with grief.
shame and spitting, he hid not his face from shame. From shame, he hid not his face from shame. From shame and spitting.
Surely he hath borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. He was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him.
Sheep have gone astray. We have turned everyone to his own way, and the Lord hath laid on him the iniquity of us all.
Thank you. all they that see him laugh him to scorn. They shoot out their lips and shake their heads, saying, he trusted in God that he would deliver him. Let him deliver him if he delight in him.
Him to scorn. They shoot out their lips and shake their heads, saying,
we trusted in God that he would deliver him. Let him deliver him.
Thy rebuke hath broken his heart. He is full of heaviness. He looked for some to have pity on him, but there was no man. Neither found he any comfort him. He was cut off out of the land of the living. For the transgressions of thy people was he stricken. But thou didst not leave his soul in hell, nor didst thou suffer thy Holy One to see corruption.
Thy rebuke hath broken his heart. He is full of heaviness. He is full of heaviness. Thy rebuke hath broken his heart. He looked for some to have pity on him, but there was no man, neither found he any to comfort him. Pity on him. neither found he any to comfort him. Was cut off out of the land of the living for the transgressions of thy people. Was he stricken?
Lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be ye lift up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of Glory shall come in. Who is this King of Glory? The Lord strong and mighty? The Lord mighty in battle? Who is this King of Glory? The Lord of hosts, he is the King of Glory.
do the nations so furiously rage together? Why do the people imagine a vain thing? The kings of the earth rise up, and the rulers take counsel together against the Lord and against his anointing.
Hallelujah, for the Lord God omnipotent reigneth. Hallelujah. The kingdom of this world is become the kingdom of our Lord and of his Christ, and he shall reign forever and ever.
Oh, I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. And the worms destroy this body, yet in my flesh shall I see God. For now is Christ risen from the dead, the first fruits of them that sleep.
Thank you.
Since by man came death, by man also came the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all die, even so in Christ shall all be made alive.
Behold, I tell you a mystery. We shall not sleep, but we shall all be changed in the moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet. The trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible.
Thank you.
Is the lamb that was slain and hath redeemed us to God by his blood to receive power and riches and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and blessing. Blessing and honor, glory and power be unto him that sitteth upon the throne and unto the lamb forever and ever. Amen.
Oh,
Thank you.